If you've built a top-down 2D game before, you'll have run into issues like this, where objects that are lower on the screen should appear in front, but here, they're not. Here's a simple script, links in the description, that you can use to address that issue. To use it, add the sortable script to your project, then subclass the scripts controlling the objects that you want to sort to sortable. This should add a sorting active attribute to your script, which you can check to set the sorting of sprites on or off. In our Vampire Survivors tutorial series, we added it to the player, enemies, and prop scripts in our game because they all need to be sorted. And our game objects become automatically sorted. Do note that all your sortable objects need to belong to the same sorting layer. If that's too complicated for you, just remove the abstract on the script and import it into your project. Then add the sortable as a component to any of your game objects. Easy. Again, note that all your sortable objects need to belong to the same sorting layer. There is a minimum distance constant that you can tweak in the script. This controls how far the object has to move before its sorting order is recalculated again. If you have many game objects in the scene that needs to be sorted, this can obviously get performance intensive. Increase this value to reduce the performance overhead of the script. The script actually works in a simple manner. Since the Y coordinates of an object controls whether or not it's in front or behind, making everything sort properly is just a matter of taking the Y coordinates and putting it into the sorting order field. Obviously, if you use the script, you will see that the Y coordinates of a sorted game object doesn't exactly correspond to the sorting order attribute. This is because we reversed the value that we put in, since objects higher up should be behind, divided the Y coordinate by our minimum distance attribute, which is 0.2 to increase the number. By doing that, we make the sorting order update every 0.2 units instead of every 1 unit. If you have any more questions about how this works, feel free to subscribe and leave a comment down below.